The God News YouTube channel, welcome aboard, once again. I got some new news for you in the world of boxing concerning Dillian, the body snatcher Whyte, and Tyson, the Gypsy King Fury, plus Alexander, the cat Usyk. Now, Dillian Whyte has suggested Tyson Fury's past exploits may have finally caught up with him. The Gypsy King suffered his first career defeat against Usyk in their undisputed showdown in May and was even nearly stopped in the ninth round. He will get an immediate shot at redemption in their squall on December 21st this year, but it is expected to be an uphill battle for the Briton. Whyte, who came up short in a domestic clash with Tyson, the Gypsy King Fury, in February 2022, believes the Briton has a chance, but only if he hasn't lost a yard from previous fights. It's heavyweight boxing, so anything is possible, and you can't write Fury off. Dillian, the body snatcher, Whyte was speaking to IFL TV, but maybe these hard fights he has had have taken a toll on him. You never know. He's human and he's had a lot of hard fights, a lot of knockdowns, and maybe it's taken a toll on him, and maybe he's not even bothered or motivated anymore. If he trains right, he's big, so stands a chance, but Usyk's self-confidence will be through the roof. And before he fought, he could outbox him, but now he knows he can't hurt him, so it will be a much more difficult task for Fury this time round. Fury has been involved in some brutal wars, including three outings against a notorious power puncher, Deontay, the bronze bomber welder. In his last fight before his defeat to Usyk, Fury had looked a shadow of himself and was knocked down by ex-UFC star Francis Ngannou last October. He went on to win, but the boxing world had begun to question if he had what it takes to beat Alexander the Cat Usyk. But he performed much better on the whole and was confident he had done enough to have his hand raised. The 35-year-old Tyson Fury even claimed he found it an easy night and had himself ahead on his own scorecard. Fury said on his Fury City YouTube channel, "I have watched the fight back lots of times and still got the same answer. I thought I won the fight. Usyk knows he didn't beat me. I thought I boxed the head right off him for most of the rounds. He landed good punch in round 8 and busted my nose in round 9. He had a 10-8 round and I gave him round 10. It was actually a lot easier than I thought it would be, the Usyk fight. People said he's a hard man to hit. I was lighting him up with 4 punch combinations and laughing at him. It was like I was in there with a local amateur boxer. I was enjoying it too much, messing around, and paid the ultimate price in round 9. That is the Gypsy King Tyson Fury while he was speaking to his Fury City YouTube channel. But Dillian Whyte coming out to suggest that maybe the hard fights that Tyson Fury has had have taken a huge toll on him. I think the 3 fights with Deontay Wilder, maybe those hard knockdowns by Deontay Wilder, especially that first fight, that round 12 knockdown, it was so emphatic. And that's why it surprised so many when Tyson Fury eventually stood up and finished off the fight in tremendous fashion. And that was scored a draw. But those big knockdowns in fight 3, Deontay Wilder knocking down Tyson Fury. At some point, you thought Deontay Wilder was going to win that fight. And he turned over Tyson Fury, knocking down Deontay Wilder. But eventually, Tyson Fury knocking out Deontay Wilder out cold in round 11 in that fight. But the second fight, it was so much of the dominance of Tyson Fury. You don't think that had that much impact on the way Tyson Fury looks in that squared circle nowadays. So the Dillian Whyte fight, it was an easy job for Tyson Fury. It wasn't anywhere near a fight that can take a huge toll on a fighter. So I don't know of the many fights that Dillian Whyte is talking about. Tyson Fury hasn't been in those huge fights that often. The hugest guy that he has fought, or the highest caliber fighter he has fought, can be maybe a Deontay Wilder, Dillian Whyte, Otto Wallin, maybe such guys. But he hasn't been in those huge battles like you can say of Anthony Joshua. Anthony Joshua has been in the ring with some tough guys, or the likes of Andy Ruiz, Alexander Usyk, Povetkin, Kubrat Purev, Joseph Parker, Dillian Whyte, so many, Francis Ngannou, so many, Vladimir Klitschko. In that Vladimir Klitschko fight, was knocked down a few times. So you're thinking, maybe the three fights with Deontay Wilder, that hard hitting Deontay Wilder can take a huge toll on you. But maybe the Francis Ngannou fight, that knockdown, you see, maybe that fight with Francis Ngannou might be the major factor of Tyson Fury showing signs of being a shadow of his former self. And because he had looked at it as a fight that will be an easy fight, but they went all the 10 rounds on the night, and some people suggested that maybe even Francis Ngannou had won that fight. So maybe that, but I don't think that had that much impact on the fight against Alexander Usyk. Usyk is extremely talented, and you would feel he was on the front foot most of the fight. He wanted to figure out how to go inside of Tyson Fury, how to let his hands go and let his left hand do the damage on Tyson Fury. And eventually, as time went on, he went on breaking down Tyson Fury, and you felt that Tyson Fury was exhausted. Usyk is a guy that has that tank in him. He can't go all the way. He can't go 15 rounds with a guy in a brutal war. And he gives you all kinds of style fights. When you look at the fight he had with Derek Chisora, you would think that maybe any guy would come up and beat up on Usyk easily. But if you go back and keenly look into that fight, you thought that Usyk approached the fight the way Derek Chisora wanted it to be, and he beat Derek Chisora at his own game. And you look at Tyson Fury, wanted to come out and maybe give a huge knockout on Alexander Usyk. It wasn't to be. Usyk is extremely talented, and he ticks all boxes in that squared circle. So Tyson Fury should watch out for that rematch. Like Alexander Zorok did come out to say that it's going to be even worse in the rematch. That's who Usyk is. For me, in my world, it will be a huge upset if Tyson Fury knocks out or even outpoints Usyk in their rematch come December 21st. But what do you think of Dillian Whyte's assessment that the huge fights and hard fights Tyson Fury has been in have taken a huge toll on him, and it will be a hell of a mountain to climb for Tyson Fury to reclaim lost glory? Place your comment in the comment section below, and let us know how you feel about all this. I sign out. Peace.